about science and think about all these cases of the multiples effect, when you're thinking, okay, when you're having thoughts, you are accessing a human mind, a human collective consciousness that is your identity, okay? And in law of one terms, that is the consciousness of the earth, which they call the sub-logos, okay? Now check this out. The sub-logos is only an aspect of the logos, which is the sun. So the sun, according to law of one, is at an octave level, the eighth density. And then you have a galactic logos, where it's all those stars put together in one mind. And then you have a universal logos, which is all the galaxies in one consciousness. So the law of one says that the whole universe of time and space, of form and experience, doesn't really exist. It's an illusion. And this, again, is really, really hard for people to understand, that you are actually potentially more real when you're dreaming than you are in your physical body. This is not real. And yet, within the illusion, it is absolutely real. Within the time that you're here, you have a body, you have pain, and the law of one also says it's very important to try to alleviate suffering. We don't want to see people suffer needlessly. We want to alleviate pain, alleviate whatever we can in the world. So service to others, making people more comfortable. And at the same time, you want to ultimately realize that this world is a hologram. It's created for us to have an experience of consciousness. And it works the same pretty much all over the universe. We have probably billions of Earth-like planets just in our galaxy. And then we have untold quadrillions of them throughout the universe. Now, in the Law of One model, we also have a living cosmos. And I've talked a lot about, and this is one of the things in the week one thing on the website, the work of Crick and Wickrama Singh, or no, I'm sorry, Hoyle and Wickrama Singh, where they looked at the dust in the galaxy, and they found that this dust is 70% hollow on the inside. Almost 99.9% of all the dust in the galaxy is hollow on the inside, and it's exactly 70% hollow. And they can tell it by the way that light reflects off of it, because it's somewhat opaque because of the hollowness. What in the world causes 70% hollowness in all this dust? Well, they looked for years, and what they finally found was freeze-dried bacteria. So the inescapable conclusion is, we know where the dust in the galaxy is coming from. It's coming off the surface of stars. That means that a star is a life factory. Every star in the whole freaking universe is creating bacteria on its surface, which then conveniently go out and freeze dry as they hit space. So what's the next thing? They hit the planets that have Earth-like water on them, and then they thaw out. And they seed that planet with life. So the life comes from the logos. So this gets really strange, because the law of one says that you are a sub-sub-logoi. That's one of the things they describe us as, sub-sub-logoi. Because we are part of the sub-logos, which is the mind of our planet, and the logos, which is the mind of our sun. Now this is a very interesting thing you can back up with scientific research.